Hello student, welcome to Aztec channel. This is Vasant Naik from Canara Engineering College. Today we will see one more concept, that is positive logic and negative logic. So we know that in binary logic, two voltage level represent the two binary digits, that is 1 and 0. If the higher of the two voltage represent a 1 and lower represents 0, then such a system is called as a positive logic system. That is, if 1, binary 1 represent a high level voltage, if binary 1 represents a high level voltage, if binary 1 represent a high level voltage, high level logic, and 0 represents a low level voltage in digital electronics, then it is called as a positive logic system or positive logic. In other way, if 0 is used to represent high level and voltage, and 1 is to represent a low level voltage in digital electronics, then it is called as a negative logic. Positive logic, we are using 1 for high level. High level means something like 5 volt. This one, high level, 5. 0 means 0. 0. It can't be 0 exactly. It is more than 0, but still 0. So then that type of logic is called as a positive logic. Negative logic, 0 used to represent a high level. We use binary 0 to represent a high level and 1 to represent a low level. Then it is called as a negative logic. So we have to see now one by one, like how this works. For example, we will take OR gate. This is the OR gate. So we have two input OR gate here. So let me draw first the truth table for the OR gate. What is the truth table for the OR gate? We have two input A and B. Truth table for the OR gate is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. And what is the output? Suppose if I take Y is the output, then 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1 is a 1. Clear. This is the truth table for the our two input OR gate. Now here 0 is used to represent a low level voltage and 1 is used to represent a high level voltage. That is, suppose in the digital circuit, if you use 0 and 5 volt, then we use binary 0 to represent a 0 volt, and 5 volt is represented by binary 1. Then this is called as a positive OR gate. Now we will change the order. Wherever 0 is there, where you put 1, and wherever 1 is there, you put 0. So let me change the circuit. Now I mean change this one. Wherever low is there you put I, and wherever I is there you put low. For example, now what I will do, same this one, I will take truth table A, B and Y. So now here 0, 0 is there. Instead of 0, I will put 1 and 1 and 1. Then here this becomes 0 becomes a, this 0 becomes a 1. This 1 becomes a 0, 0. Then here 0, 1, 0. Then here 0, 0, 1. Sorry, last one is a 0. Now you see the order 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, and you see output is equal to 0, 0, 0, 1. That means it is equivalent to this one, AND gate. So I can say positive OR gate in positive logic is equal to AND gate in negative logic. OR gate in positive logic is equal to AND gate in negative logic. So this is the one thing you have to remember here. So next, So next, based on this positive logic and negative logic, we can prove the following four relations. What are the four relations? First one is, we have already seen, positive R is equal to negative AND. So in the exam, they may ask you to prove positive AND is equal to negative R. So that time, what you have to do? You have to take an AND gate, and you have to prove, by changing the logic levels, you have to prove it is negative R. Similarly, you can prove positive NOR is equal to negative NAND. Then positive NAND is equal to, fourth one is, positive NAND is equal to negative NOR. So very, very important. So this logic systems, this logic levels, different logic levels are used in different types of electronic design in order to reduce the complexity of the circuit.